museums are a mirror of political and social changes. We have already talked about the social role of the museums and their value as community centers and places for the creation of identity and social cohesion. Now let's focus on their political and economic impact. First of all, why political? Museums are social and urban actors, so they should have a political role. We have already said that museums contribute to the intellectual growth of the society by educating people. So they can be considered awakeners of public and thus political consciousness. They should become like forums where the main issues of our times can be addressed by means of the mediation of historical and artistic goods. Museums can and must intervene in the social and political life of the city where they are. Neutrality should not be accepted anymore for museums and cultural institutions, which instead have to actively take action. Mike Murawski, in a recent article on the forum Art Museum Teaching, said that museums are catalysts for cohesion in a society rife with intolerance, discrimination, inequality, social isolation, and self-segregation. Museums are places where it is possible to make parallels between historical periods and happenings, confronting ourselves with different points of view and opinions, in order to open our minds to a more respectful and rational vision of the world where we live. History is a useful tool to understand our present and direct our actions towards contemporary social problems. As Francis Haskell said in his book The Ephemeral Museum, an exhibition in a well-chosen venue and designed in the right way can be a strong means of propaganda and can convey political messages. The impact of the museum on the society is also related to its economic implications. Museums are cultural institutions, but they are also market-driven. So the changes should depend also on audience demand, at least in part. Therefore, the challenge is to satisfy the market and the visitors without lowering the cultural level. A solution could be to act on more points of view and offer within the same exhibition slightly different levels of reading and learning for different types of audience. The main sources of financing for museums are public fundings, private sponsorships and partnerships, incomes from tickets, shops, catalogs and other events. As James Bradburn, the director of Pinacoteca di Brera in Milan, said, a museum should not entirely depend on one of these sources, as it would be too risky. A good museum director with managerial competencies should instead point at a reasonable division of income from these three voices. Cultural institutions can also have other sources of financing, for example crowdfunding, which is the practice of funding a project by raising money from a large number of people, which contribute a relatively small amount, typically via the internet. In this way, consumers turn into co-producers. In the second week, we touched upon the roles of curator and manager, which should be complementary. We should add that museums also need management plans in order to guarantee sustainability. Generally speaking, a museum director should accomplish these roles, one connected to the other. To organize activities and resources by dividing roles among people and coordinating them. To manage and find the economic resources. To monitor and evaluate the activities of the museum. A thorough consideration on the economic value of museums is needed. We must keep in mind that tourism is not the only purpose of museums. In fact, cultural heritage is not simply an instrument to make money, but culture is firstly at the service of the society. Museums can obviously attract people by giving more value to the artistic or historical objects exhibited. In this way, people become proud of their heritage and their participation to cultural events increases. Anyway, culture and arts, when managed in an efficient way, can bring significant economic developments for the society. So good and well-planned investments in culture can make a country outstanding. Museum can be also a way to redevelop critical areas such as the suburbs. We will see more detail in the next lesson the relationship which should exist between the museum and its territory. For now, we can say that a museum has the power to connect the center with the suburbs. To bring parts of the museums or temporary installations outside the museums in apparently unrelated contexts, such as the peripheral areas or places of passages like the streets, could be a successful idea to stimulate people's curiosity. In this way, a gradually higher number of citizens can feel more engaged by art and history, and perhaps visit museums. One of the main efforts by museums operators and curators should be that of transforming their institutions in museums that really matter and that have a strong influence in the social, political, and economic life of the cities. In a world that is exponentially more globalized and economically driven, it is necessary to create cultural spaces where personal reflections as well as public dialogues can incite to actions and taking stances.